Look at the sky, the stars above. Such a beautiful night. Day in the moonlight, and lay away, lost in paradise.
From the minute that we met Cameron, when he showed up to all the craziness that was going on in our family, I could tell he was a great, great person. The way he looked at Sarah, he opened doors, dads loved that sort of stuff. It was like, this is working pretty good. And then they moved to San Diego, so again, I got a little bit leery about that because she was going to be far away. But we went down there and we met the Shimizus, who's our family now, and all the friends and their family. And I knew everything was going to be okay. I talked to Don briefly. He probably doesn't remember. And I asked him, is everything going to be okay? And he said, yeah. So you did. So I took the dad's advice. So we are so happy to have Cameron.
Just look at the sky, the stars above. Such a beautiful night. In the moonlight, and lay your heart lost in paradise.
One thing that we saw right off the bat was Sarah and Cameron are very happy, and that's so important in a relationship. So I'm very, very glad for that. And I got another son, and he likes sports, which is really good too.
Sarah, I think the first time we met you, me and Deb thought maybe this is the one after all those years of Cameron doing whatever he does in college. And so maybe this is the one, maybe he's going to settle down and you kind of just fit into the family so easily. There's not a lot of things I'm proud of in my life, to be honest with you, but I'm extremely proud to be the father myself. I guess when you look back at Cameron, you put passion into everything you did. If you bring just a little bit of that passion to your marriage, your life will be as happy as mine and mom's has been for the last 36 years.
Come on, Charlie, don't go home. I don't feel like being alone. Have a drink, take it easy, and dance with me. Seems to me she drinks at night all the tears that she has cried. And she smiles at me and says, I'm all right. She's a sleeping queen from a painted scene. When she holds me in her arms, too big for me. She's a painted queen from a sleeping
beautiful
scene.
Just kiss you look amazing
me one more time.
I call it.
Leave
it's been.
The town.
Cleavage,
the trail.
She's not affected by
you
her
look great
beauty when she's telling me her story. With that cheap coat, a goddess name, and that funny talk.
You're sweating so much.
Seems to me she drinks at night.
You look great.
Tears,
beautiful.
It's exactly
it's
what
perfect
you thought it was. A little bit of cleavage, smile a little bit of that.
I love it.
Having a good time. All this anticipation.
I know.
She's a sleeping queen from a painted scene. When she holds me in her arms, too sweet for me.
Greatest marriages are built on teamwork. And that's really important. And you guys are a good team. Mutual respect and admiration for one another. And I know you guys admire the way that you work and what you put together, and a never-ending love and grace. So just keep that in mind.
That's all right.
Used to go to the crowd, baby, it's a no-brainer. It ain't that hard to choose. Him or me, be for real, baby, it's a no-brainer. You got your mind on loose. Go hard and watch the sun rise. One night I'll change your whole life. Outside your top, baby, it's a no-brainer. I'll put them up if you with me, yeah.
I've been basically through every stage of life together. You are the person that I go to for all my advice. And almost 10 years ago, we decided to plan a trip to Vegas, as we've all heard. And this is the weekend that Sarah and me finally met. I guess what they say, what happens in Vegas doesn't stay in Vegas.
But when you're riding in the drive, you can't explain it.
Shimmy, I heard you call her your best friend, but she'll never be your best friend. It helps you find your friend.
Although I may not have been there when Sarah and Cameron met, like most of you here were, I did read the wedding website in preparation for this moment. And I have become well acquainted with the classic friends to lover story. And I can say that with all my heart, that I'm happy that even after 3+ years of being friends with Sarah, Cameron finally got the courage to ask her on a proper date. Sarah, I couldn't be happier that you and Cameron moved down to San Diego, and I've had the pleasure of getting to know you better. And I am proud to consider you a great friend. And if you and Cameron ever need anything, know that I am a phone call away or a short walk down the street.
I ain't got no chain. Not on the list, I ain't got no name. We'll be in this bed, and I'm not no lame. I keep it been fickle, and I'm not gonna change. A lot of these hoes messy. I just want you and your bestie. Yo, don't gotta answer for whenever you text me. It's multiple choice, and they all wanna test me.
Today, family and friends to witness Sarah and Cameron as they exchange their vows of marriage and begin their lifelong journey together as husband and wife.
I have been friends with both of these two for a very, very long time. Cameron, I have known for more than a decade now, since the beginning of our glorious time together in college at Cal Poly. Some of you might not know, Cameron, the house he lived in college on Hathaway, we would affectionately refer to as the reservation. It's true, the house was littered with abandoned living room furniture and missing window blinds, curiously stained carpet. But what I always admired about you, Cameron, despite the appalling and unsanitary conditions of that collegiate home, you never turned away a guest in need of a couch to sleep on at night. I could have been a friend from out of town, visiting fraternity alumni, even Carlson's dad. Didn't matter who was in need. Your door was always open, Cameron. He showed a level of selflessness and hospitality that is truly admirable and will certainly make you a phenomenal husband.
I'll be your excuse. You go wrong now. Stick out of the crowd, baby, it's an no-brainer. It ain't that hard to choose. Him or me, be for real, baby, it's an no-brainer. You got your mind unloose. Go hard and watch the sun rise. One night, I'll change your whole life. I'm tired, baby, it's an no-brainer. I'll put him up if you with me, yeah, 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 yeah. Whoa, whoa, oh, 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 put 'em high, yeah, 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 yeah. Whoa, whoa, oh, 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 put 'em
high. Sarah, since the moment I met you, it was clear you have an energy and positivity about you that is truly infectious.
My, oh my. Lord.
I've never seen a dance floor you didn't own.
I just can't hardly wait.
A party bus you didn't shine on. An aux cord you didn't hijack. From day one, you fit in seamlessly with our dysfunctional group of Cal Poly misfits, and I am so happy that you and Cameron ended up finding each other.
And I'm starting to.
I see the way you look at him, and it's clear you love him even more than you love your cordless Dyson vacuum. And Cameron is lucky to be able to call you his bride. Against all odds, we found our way, and you two have found your life partner. And I can proudly say I have seen over and over again how happy you two make each other. I can say with conviction that this union is one founded upon the genuine qualities and characteristics that will make for a beautiful and everlasting marriage.
Fast now, like tires on the road. But I don't mind.
You're very handsome, and I cannot wait to be your wife. Let me know if I need to speak up for the people in the back. All right. I'm very used to holding a microphone and rapping, so this is perfect. I feel so special that all these people traveled to Mexico for us. You and I would not be here without those who have contributed to some pretty crucial milestones in our relationship. A lot of them are up here with us today. Jenna, for realizing that Cal Poly was a better school than Chico. Introducing us after you guys met at Cal Poly, Mr. and Mrs. Church, for helping to attempt to set up a first date, which you bailed on, but this is not the Tom Brady roast. Shelby Harold, for her epic birthday trip to Scottsdale, where you told me you loved me for the first time in the most romantic location at the Talking Stick Casino pool party. So many amazing memories, and I can't wait to make more this weekend. It's been almost 10 years since we've met. Although we can both agree it may not have been love at first sight, I think what we have is much more special. After 4 years of friendship in San Francisco, we really got to see all sides of each other. I saw how you are an incredibly loyal friend to your people, and you will spend any amount of money or time to make sure that everyone is having fun. You were also able to see all of this craziness, and you still chose to pursue a relationship. I'm really grateful for that. And the espresso martinis at Reed and Grinnell for the extra courage. Throughout my life, I'd watched friends move in and out of relationships. A part of me always wondered when it would be my time. In college, a friend said to me, "Someone great is waiting for you, and I have a feeling your first love will be your last." And that's exactly what happened. Not a lot of people get to marry their first love, and I'm so ready to share many more firsts with you. You're truly one of a kind. You are able to pop into any group immediately and make a connection with them. And that's one of my favorite qualities about you. You're incredibly patient. I know I am a lot to handle. And you always seem to know exactly when I need a hug or some tough love. You embrace my rapping, my party bus behavior, and my obsession with cleanliness, aka my Dyson. I've never felt like I needed to be anything other than my true self around you. And I think that's what makes us really great partners. When I reflect on our last 5+ years, you've taught me many things, but two really stand out. Our little family is number one, and that life doesn't always need to be so serious. I love how you always go with the flow and you never let anything bug you, and you've really taught me to be much more relaxed, and I'm so appreciative of that.
as we look into our future, I'm so excited. I'm overwhelmed with excitement. Our children are so lucky to have such a thoughtful, loving father. And I can't wait to do our favorite things for the rest of our life, like ordering so many appetizers that the entree ends up being tomorrow's breakfast because we're not even hungry when they come. Fighting any excuse to treat ourselves to something delicious, secretly competing in workout classes, even though we both admit that we're not, and dancing in the living room after a few glasses of wine. Now for my promises. I promise to ask less questions during movies and watch every sporting event that you've placed bets on, which is really a lot if you guys know that. I promise to limit my eye rolling when you talk about glory days of high school football.
What makes your house a home?
Jeez, Torrey Pines. More seriously, I promise to never leave the house without a kiss, and I promise to tell you I love you every single day. I know life with you will be an adventure, and I'm so grateful we get to do it together. I love you.
First of all, you look absolutely stunning. Can we get a round of applause for Sarah?
Yeah! Oh, yeah.
I still can't believe that you actually agreed to marry me, so that's a good win for me. I want to start off by going back to when we first met. As Church mentioned, it was Vegas, and I really distinctly remember meeting you and thinking for the first time that there was no chance that I could ever be enough for someone like you. Obviously, so beautiful, outgoing, funny, making everyone laugh, and just lit up the room when you came in. And then, well, there was me, just kind of there. It wasn't love the first time we met, but a few years later, we'll add at Sean's/Todd's house. We still don't really know who owned that house in the marina. I remember being lucky enough to somehow have gotten your attention. We spent the entire night, just the two of us talking on the couch for hours on end. After that night, it felt like something changed. Felt like I had a chance, and I knew that worst case, we'd end up as friends, so it wasn't too bad. But after that also, I remember being so scared to take the leap. What if I went for it and it didn't work? Couldn't imagine what that future would look like. So thank God, and probably thanks to some alcohol, you end up feeling the same, and we did end up sharing that first kiss at the Classy Comic Club, which if you've been there, you know. And after that night, it was like it was always meant to be. Life with you has always just been so easy. We balance each other out perfectly. We always make each other laugh, and you're truly my best friend. I couldn't see myself with anyone else in the world, and there's no one else I'd rather be with for the rest of my life. You put up with all my crazy tendencies and habits. You spend 17 Sundays a year with me, watching the Chargers lose, yet again in the fourth quarter, down one score, watching the Padres blow yet another lead, and drinking bottles of wine at our family dinners, listening to stories of how awesome I was at high school football. I promise to eventually move on from that. We've been through so much together in the last 5 years. COVID in San Francisco with my fucking crazy liquor store neighbor, moving to San Diego, getting Piper, and most importantly, preparing for our future family. Being with you is undoubtedly the best decision I've ever made in my life. You make me better in an endless amount of ways, but just to list a few. As one friend once said, you've turned me from an insufferable frat boy to a somewhat respectable human being. You've made me more compassionate, thoughtful, and the way that you always put your friends first is something that I'll always work to learn from you. Being with you has not only increased my ability to love, but also my capacity for love. I want to make a few promises to you in front of our best friends and family. I promise to always love you and support you in everything you do in life. I promise to always laugh with you, even if it's an Instagram meme that we've both seen 100 times, or a reality TV show that I say I don't like, but you know I really do. And I promise to be the best father to our future children, because I know that you will be the best mother and you deserve the best partner in this life. I love so much about you. How you care so much about our future family, how happy you are when we take walks with Piper, how you try to flare your nostrils, how you can break it down and rap every song from our childhood, how much you love Taco Bell and McDonald's, how much you love my crazy family and have made us all so much closer, how patient you are with me, and most of all, I love that you are mine forever.
Cameron, as you place your ring on Sarah's finger, please repeat after me. Sarah, I give you this ring.
Sarah, I give you this ring.
As a reminder that I will love, honor, and cherish you.
As a reminder that I will love, honor, and cherish you.
In all times.
In all times.
In all places.
In all places.
Always and forever.
Always and forever.
May the vows and promises you have made today be as ever-present in your hearts as these rings are on your fingers. In the presence of your family and friends that have gathered here today, you have spoken the words and performed the rites which unite your lives in matrimony. By the power vested in me by the state of Nayarit and the Universal Life Ministries Church Online, it is my legal right and my greatest privilege to now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Shimizu.
Rather than going into all these things that Shimmy and I have done together and experiences, Shimmy, I want to give you some advice. Because I think I'm pretty qualified to do so. No, if you want Sarah to dance, just play barrier rap music or Tasty. 9, always love her and make her laugh. And 10, whatever you tell Sarah, know she's gonna tell me. Sarah, I'll love you forever. And Shimmy, I hope you love growing old with Sarah as much as I've loved growing up with her. Love you guys, cheers.
Baby girl,
when it's cold,
your mom and I wouldn't change a hair on your head. We're so happy to have you as our daughter. Sarah's always been witty, always been kind, always got along with everybody. So this is tough giving up your daughter. You know, you love your son, but there's a bond between a dad and a daughter, and it's always protective. And now I know that Cameron, you got her, and everything's going to be good, because prior to that, I would make Liam Neeson look like a sissy if anything ever went wrong. So, like I said, the only thing that I would change is you should have continued to play basketball in high school. Tennis wasn't it.
Don't forget my love. hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How am I gonna be an optimist about this? How am I gonna be an optimist about this? But if you close your eyes. We'll be right back.